y'all. Welcome back to class at Move with Sable. If you're here right now, it's because you might be experiencing some discomfort in your hip and your sciatic nerve. So this video is going to walk you through four stretches to help relieve hip and sciatic nerve pain. Now, there's actually nothing wrong with your sciatic nerves. It's your piriformis muscle, which is a deep glute muscle that is pressing on that nerve, and that's what causes the discomfort. So all of these stretches are going to create space in your glutes, in that hip socket, to help relieve some of that pressure and that tension. So you're not going to want to just stretch though, you also want to strengthen that seat muscle so that it activates the way it should and it doesn't cause a lot of that discomfort. So check out my bar for hips video. That one focuses a lot on hip stability and strength. And we're gonna go through these four exercises together, about 30 or 40 seconds each stretch. And hopefully you find some relief if that is what you're here for today. We're gonna get started in child's pose. So my knees are gonna be at least the width of my mat. I'm really thinking about my hip flexors right here. I'm gonna bring my palms to my heels because that's gonna pull my hips down in the back right here. So here, think about the shape of your spine from your neck all the way to your tailbone, and also take that little extra pull with your arms to pull those hips down in the front and tailbone towards the mat in the back. And always, you don't have to be perfectly still in stretches. You can wiggle around, see where you need to find some release. And from here, we're gonna sit up and we're gonna take a leg up in pigeon. So let me start with my right side so you can see. So I'm trying to pull that leg up as close to parallel in the front as I can and getting my left hip flexor as open towards the floor as I can. So I like to walk it down and release into the floor here. So notice you don't release into your arms. Don't hold yourself. You want those hips, you want gravity to work on those hips to open. Remember, visualize creating space. And breathe through your stretches. And do the same thing on the other side. Now this might be a series that you have to do more than once. It's only about three and a half minutes. And the first time around, you might be really tight. You might want to come back and do it again in that second time and get more range, get more depth, more space. That's the theme of this space. Create space, open. And then from here, we're gonna sit up into a cobbler or a butterfly stretch. So just as comfortable as you can get here, making those seat bones out of the way, pushing the hips forward, okay? And I'm never still in this one. I'm usually always flexing my knees up and down. I'm still wiggling, I'm scooting. Just as much as it's your stretch, it's your body. Don't let anybody tell you that you can't wiggle or move if you need to. And then from here, we're gonna peel it on back into lying triangle stretches. So I'm gonna cross my left ankle on top of my right knee, pull that up, relax your upper body, pull that in and stretch. So you wanna feel this right in here. That's where you're trying to pull that space out, opening in the hip joint. And then just release that side. And then you do the same thing on the other side. Pull it up and in. That always feels good for me on the right side. This is also a good stretch if you have somebody to help you stretch at home. They're gonna stand behind your foot there and let you press into them, and you can push your knee away from your body to create some more room in your hips. All right, y'all, it's as simple as that. four moves right there to help relieve some of that hip and sciatic pain. If you found this stretch useful, go ahead and give me a like right here. I'd really appreciate it. And make sure that you're subscribed so that you can join me here for class more often.